God to what?
Answer.
Or you can say, where there is a man to pray, there is a call to answer. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you have a man in your family that prays, then there is a God that will answer his prayers. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning I will start my message by asking some few questions. I want you to think about it and see how many can answer the question in your spirit mind. How much confidence do you have in your prayers? How many confidence do you have in your own prayers? Or do you depend on others to pray for you? Did you stop praying because you think God does not answer your prayers? Did you stop praying because you think God does not answer your prayers? When you pray, do you really expect an answer? When you pray, do you expect an answer? If not, if you don't expect an answer when you pray, I want to encourage you from today. When you pray, have an expectation.
Hallelujah.
Expect an answer. Because God really hears our prayers. God really answers our prayers. And even right now, He wants to answer your prayers. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
Now a man can write answer or receive an instant answer to prayers. Just this week. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The other part of this week, the man wife came to bear some issue in her left eye. And some heaviness in the left eye. Can I say amen?
Amen.
There's a part of the eye called the iris. Upon that place at where she was feeling the heaviness and pain in her eyes. And then she felt the soap of her eye was changing color. And it went on for a few hours, and she felt that something wrong was going on with her. She didn't know what was going on. So after she thought that it was something common, and a few hours after the pain still intensified in her eye, she decided to go to her husband. Asked her husband to pray along with her. So her husband held her by the hand, and he laid her hands upon her head and prayed for her, anointed her. When he got to pray, he looked at her, looking to see as to whether there was a healing in the eye. When he asked her, do you still feel the pain? He said, yeah, I still feel the pain. When he looked in the eye, in fact, the eye started turning more red in Jesus' name. So he just told her, let's believe God that you are going to heal in Jesus' name. Let her have faith and trust God that you're already healed. And that will settle it. Now, as the day goes and the night goes, the feeling begins to intensify. And, the only thing she thought about, it's already late, I'll go to bed, and tomorrow morning, probably I'm just going to check it out to see what happened in her eyes. So they went to bed. The next morning, when she woke up, the very first thing she experienced, there were no pain in her eye anymore. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
There were no pain in her eye anymore. She ran to the mirror to check her eyes, and she saw her eye had clear. It was normal. No itching, no scratches, no blueness, no redness. Her eye was completely healed. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
God answered the prayer supernaturally. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. There was a man to pray. There was a woman to pray.
Yeah.
And God immediately answered them. God is looking for a man and a woman that is available to pray.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God only wants, He only needs a praying man and a praying woman. And you can find a praying man and a praying woman in a family. You can find a praying man and a praying woman in a community, in a nation, in the church. God we answer them because He is an answering God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The God will answer. That's what the Bible says in Jeremiah 1 verse 12. It says that the Lord will hasten to perform what? Perform His word. He will hasten to perform it. So when there is a pregnant, God will hasten to perform His wonders. He will hasten to perform
miracles in our life. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you can pray, God will answer the prayers. God is ready to answer the prayers. Now, I want you to come with me to Matthew chapter 7, verse 11. It says, ask, and it will be what? Give it to you. Seek, and you shall have. Knock, and the door will be what? Open. Now, there is a clear indication from the scripture that God is asking us to ask. He's asking us to seek. He's asking us to knock. What that scripture tells us is that we should pray. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Asking is praying, is talking to God. Talk to God about your situation. Don't be afraid of God. God is not a big hell of a stuff, something that you cannot approach. God is not so mighty that you cannot approach. In fact, because he's mighty, that allows you to approach him. So I say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we are called to ask, to seek, and to knock. Then the Father says, for everyone who asks, what? Receive. Everyone who seeks, what? Find. And everyone who knocks, the door what? Is open unto them. So the scripture has already clear to us that if you seek, you will find. If you ask, you will receive. If you knock, the door will be open. It is clear in scripture. All God is saying to you yourself, ask whenever you have need.
Amen.
Seek if you need to find me. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Knock if those are closed, they will be open unto you.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And I love this part. And it said, or what man is there among you if his son asks for bread? Will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for fish, will he give him a serpent? If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more is the Father who is in heaven? Give good gifts to those who ask him. Bible is clear as making us understand that we evil, we know how to get good gifts. There is nobody here that your child will come to you and say, give me some bread, you'll get a spoon. Give me fish, you'll get a stick. You will give your child exactly what the child asks for, especially when the child is loving you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, Bible says, God qualifies us as being wicked. We've been wicked and we know how to get good gifts to our children. What more about God? When you ask him, he will give you what you desire. He will give you your heart desire. So all he asks you to do is what? Ask. And you will receive. That's all. Just ask him. When you are down, ask him. When you are in trouble, ask him. When you need money, ask him. You need job, ask him. You need healing, ask him. He's the God of our healing and deliverance. He's the God of miracle. He's the God that will supply our needs according to his riches in the heart. Glory. So ask him. He will never leave or forsake you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, in this scripture, we see Jesus pleading with us. It's an appeal. I beg you, in fact, some other Bible say it this way. He said, ask, I ask you to ask. It started with ask, I ask you what? Ask. Seek, I beseech you to seek. Knock, I ask you to knock. So God is begging. He's pleading with us. My daughter, my son, ask me whatever you need. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ask me. I will hasten to perform it. All I need for you to do is to open your mouth and ask.
Amen.
And I will fill your mouth.
Amen.
With laughter. With wonders. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So as of today, I want to encourage you, if you have not been asking God, it is about time to begin to ask God of your needs.
Amen.
Don't ask men, ask God. Because when you ask God, Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Don't ask the name first. Ask God who are first. Amen. Ask God first. You need healing? Ask God first. Then go to the doctor. You need deliverance? Ask God first. You can go for prayer meeting. Ask God. God is sufficient enough to bless you. He has more than enough to bless you. There is no lack you have that God does not have, that God does not have a supplement for. He does not have enough to give. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
He will give you. All he wants you to do is what? Ask. Tell you what's the name of?
Ask.
Say ask. God is not just a man. Ask him. Now, do not let the devil deceive you in thinking that God will not hear you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's the mind we have. Will God hear me? Look at where I am. Me too, if God will answer my prayer. Listen to me. It is you, it is your prayer that God will answer. It is your very prayer that God will answer. If you sincerely come to God, believe me and trust in Him that He's able to do it. I got a news for you. It will shock you that God will surprise you. Somebody say amen. God will surprise you. That big miracle will come before you. Somebody say
amen.
All you need to know that your prayer is powerful and God will answer your prayer. No matter your situation, if there is a man to pray, there is a God to what? Answer. If only you can pray, God will answer. Somebody say amen. God will answer your prayer. You just need to step out and begin to pray. Make the devil shake. Somebody say amen. God loves you equally as He loves any man of God. He loves you equally as He loves any prophetess, any apostle, any archbishop or pope. He loves you equally with them. So your prayer is also, can also be heard, just as the prayer of the pope will be heard. Somebody say amen. Don't underestimate yourself. Don't deny yourself. Don't look down on yourself. Prayer out of your mouth can bring deliverance. Prayer out of your mouth can bring healing. Prayer out of your mouth can bring miracle. Begin to use your mouth and declare what you want to see. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All you need to do, fear of worship, is to get your prayer. All you need to do to get your prayer answer is that one. Love God. Love God and the blood of Jesus. And let right. That's all. And your prayer will be answered.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So pray, believe it. And pray, continuous prayer. Why? Because where there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer.
Yeah.
Let's go to Luke chapter 8, 1 or 18, 1 to 7, and 7 to 8. I will not read, I will just talk about it. Stop. Bible says, Jesus for this, let me read the verse 1 first. Verse 1 says, then He spoke a parable to them, that men always ought to pray and not lose heart. Now, Jesus spoke a parable, but this parable was to tell us that we ought to pray. The word ought to pray means we must pray. Hallelujah. Nothing must stop us from what? Praying. Men ought to pray. So no matter how you feel, pray. When you are disappointed, pray. When you are confused, pray.
Amen.
When you have no money, pray.
Amen.
When you have money, pray. When you have no children, pray.
Amen.
When everyone turn their back on you, pray.
Amen.
When things are well, pray.
Amen.
All when life is tough and tough, pray.
Amen.
When shame and disgrace is passing your way, pray.
Amen.
When men talk about of evil against you, pray.
Amen.
For men ought to what? Pray.
Amen.
Then remember the Bible. It said, there was an old woman, an old widow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who have nobody but her son. She came to this king for justice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The king was known to be a judge, to judge over cases. And she came to the king for what? Justice. The king would not even hear her plea. He would not even hear her case. But she never gave up.
Amen.
She continued coming. Though he don't want to see me, I will come. Though he don't want to hear me, our time. God is send me our time. Oh, nothing will stop me because I want justice.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Bible says the evil king. In fact, God is talking as one evil king. The evil king said to me, is like, though I am evil, and I don't fear God. Said, though I'm evil and I don't fear God, I will give the woman justice. So that she will not wear me off.
Amen.
So the Bible says she will not attack me.
Yeah.
She will not wear me off. I'm just disgusted at her. I'm just tired of her seeing every day. Let me just yield her out and give her what? Justice. What is God saying to us in our scripture? He has said to us that we should not cease. We should continue praying until our what? Prayer is answered. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Until our kings come.
Amen.
It's a continuous process. Don't stop praying. Because where you pray, God is there to answer. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you are able to pray, God is able to answer.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
If you're able to pray about a situation, God is able to give you a solution for that situation. Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Now, Jesus called attention to what the unjust judge said. Okay? He said, I'll give her justice. Or else, you know, the woman will wear me out. So I'll just give her justice. So as we continue to pursue our life, let us continue praying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will answer us. Don't give up. Because it seems now that the problem is still existing. Don't give up because what you are praying for, it seems like there is no answer. Continue praying. God will meet your need. God will answer your prayers. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, prayer is not like a fire extinguisher. Ever look for fire extinguisher?
Yeah.
All right. Prayer is not like that. Fire extinguisher is hitting the wall. You never have need for it until fire comes. And you pray up. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Prayer is not like that. You don't have to have fire before you call for the scripture. When it comes to prayer, it's everyday thing. You must use it.
Amen.
You must open your mouth and talk to God.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You cannot wait until there is an issue. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you open your mouth to pray, you are that man that is praying. And that God who answer will answer your prayers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't have to wait when things get bad. You don't have to wait when things get tough.
Amen.
You don't have to wait when all else has loosened up.
Amen.
Now is the time to pray.
Amen.
While you have life, you must pray.
Amen.
While you have breath, you must pray. You must talk to God on every day. Every moment of the day. Talk to God. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Bible tells in 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 10, there was a man by the name of Jabez. Jabez was born in shame. He was born in disgrace. He was born in sorrow. His mother called him Jabez because she went through pain and sorrow. Disappointment and failure in life. So she named him Sorrow, Jabez. When Jabez grew up, going through all kinds of difficult time, all kinds of hard situation in his life. I mean, he smelled himself. He could not take it anymore. And after he got to reason with life, he came to a place and said, I just can't take this anymore. My life is just a piece of mess. All my days I have known no peace. I have seen no happiness in my life. So Joshua went up this morning and he said, oh God, oh God, help me, deliver me, bless me, enlighten my cause. Hallelujah. Keep me from evil. Hallelujah. Jabez opened his mouth. He never kept his mouth closed in his situation. It came to a place in his life that he could not take it anymore. And he said, Lord, I must open my mouth. Because you told me to what? Ask you. You told me to what? Seek you. You told me to what? Knock the door. So you open your mouth and say, oh God. Hallelujah. Forgive me. Have mercy on me. Enlighten my cause. Somebody say amen. Listen to me, word by word, what he said. And Jabba called unto the Lord of Israel, say, O thou who hast blessed me indeed, and enlightened my cause that my hands might be with you, and thou would keep me from evil. Your hands will be over my life. You have blessed me, Lord. Bless me and enlarging my cause. I need to be blessed. I need to be favored. Expand me, Lord. It's time to loosen up.
Amen.
It's time to take me along. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And the last part, what happened in that scripture? Look at the last part. And it says here, and God granted him that which you are requested. And God granted him. God answered his what? Prayer. There was a man to pray. And because there was a man to pray, there was a God to what? Answer. That is what that man. He was tired of his frustration. There was a man to pray. That man was Jabez. He was tired of his frustration. And the God who answered him was tired. Answer his prayers. I stop by to let you know, if you are tired with your pain, if you are tired with your suppression, if you are tired with your depression, if you are tired with what you're going through, you must rise up and pray. Because there is a God to answer. Somebody say hallelujah. He will not neglect you. He will not forsake you. He will not abandon you. He will answer your prayer. Somebody shout hallelujah. Bible let me know that Daniel was a teenager when they were captured from the land and taken to the land called Babylon. Hallelujah. He and other Israelites were captured. Daniel was brought into that land, and it was because of his smartness and his wisdom, he was placed into a school to learn how to serve in the court of the king, to serve in the palace. And he began to serve in the palace. And because of his wisdom, his smartness, because of his activeness and good work experience, good man as working, the king favored him and set him above all other great men that were there. And they became envious. They began to jealous him. How can a foreigner come to my country and become my boss? Hallelujah. I think he brought medicine with him. Somebody say amen. Why would the king favor him? The king and myself belong in this country. This man is a foreigner. And the king have favored him and placed him over us. What is this? And they all begin to plan evil against him. But the Bible said, for every evil they plan, they could not catch him. This means the enemy will not catch you in their evil.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Every trick they are playing up against your life, you will not fall for it. Shout glory. You will not fall for it because you are a praying person.
Amen.
And because you pray, God will answer you. Somebody shout glory. Every way out, they try to trap him. Bible says they found no fault in him. They were not able to trap him. Then finally, they decide to put a scheme together. They went to the king with a big lie. We have met as a council. We met all the big men in the place, and they all agreed to what we are about to tell you, king. This thing here, we want to do. You have been serving us so much. You are a great king. Now we want to extract all our worship to you. So you're going to get the oil. We're going to build an image. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That you are going to praise that image. And the king thought that was a very good thing. Because he was told that everybody has agreed, everybody has agreed to the proposal. They never went to David, but Daniel. They never consulted him about their plans. Because their plan was a conspiracy against David, Daniel. They wanted to destroy him. So the Bible says, the king agreed, and the law passed. That nobody has prayed to no other law besides their image. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When Daniel heard that, the first thing he did, he went to his room, the room upstairs, window open, and he went to worship his God. In fact, Daniel went and prayed three times that day. The news got to the king. Daniel was arrested. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The king was not in favor of this. But he could not do nothing else with that because it was a seal, it was for a seal. That is a law that cannot be changed. Daniel was his best friend. Daniel was close to his heart. But there was something he could do. He could not withdraw his friend. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
The Bible says Daniel was sentenced to death for worshiping another God besides the English. And as you know the story, he was thrown down into the lion's den. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Because of Daniel's prayer, there is no one that survived upon your, I will throw you down into the den. Before you can hit the ground, you are already in the mouth of the lions. Because they are kept hungry for days. Before you can touch the ground, they scatter into pieces. But Daniel was sitting in the middle of them, and they were all around him, they were keeping conversation. Listen to me. Your enemy will not harm you in Jesus' name. All your evil plan, it will not touch you in Jesus' name. Ah, they will not destroy you. They are wasting their own time.
Yes, Lord.
The teeth of the lion will not touch you. The claw of the lion will not touch you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Because of your prayer, lion will run away from you. Because of your prayer, lion will flee from you. In fact, you will embrace you. You will set the lions. Hallelujah. Shout glory. No devil in hell will destroy you because you are a praying woman. You are a praying man. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. I command you today, rise up and pray. Rise up and pray. Pray in your home. Pray at your job. Pray in your car. Pray in the street. Pray in the marketplace. Pray when you are talking. Pray when you are sitting. Pray when you are walking. Because when people, if that is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. Somebody say hallelujah. Our God is an answering God. Our God is a prayer consuming God. He will not let you down. He will not turn his back at you. When you ask, he will receive. When you knock, the door will be open to you. When you seek, you will find. Somebody say hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
There were two men who were there to pray. If there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer. There were two men in the midnight hour who were chained on their legs, chained on their hands, and they were put in prison, and their name was Paul and what? Silas. Father said, at midnight, they understood that every ass. God will answer. Every knock, the door will be open. Every seek will be fine. They understood that everyone that seek will be fine. Everyone that knock, the door is open to them. So Bible said, at midnight, they begin to knock. At midnight, they begin to seek. At midnight, they begin to ask. Father, where are you? Father, have mercy. Father, the enemy wants to destroy us, but we believe in you. You are mighty, you are powerful. No weapon of the enemy shall prosper on our life. Father said, the Bible said, at midnight.
Amen.
There was a man to pray. And because there was a man to pray, there was a violent effort. There was a what? Violent effort. Listen to me. God is about to release a violent earthquake. in your camp. He's about to release the wrath, violent earthquake in your camp. He's about to release a violent earthquake against your enemy. A violent earthquake against those that have come against you.
And Bible says, the chain will broken off your legs. The chain will broken off their hands.
Hallelujah.
The chain will broken off the kids.
Amen.
Locks will broken. Those feet to the left and to the right. Listen to me. Everything that is holding you bound, everything that is keeping you from moving forward, if you will rise to pray, this thing will loose out of your life. If you rise to pray, this thing will put loose in your life. If you rise to pray, those things will vanish from your life. I speak to your life right now. Those chains around your life, those chains around your legs, those chains around your future, I command it by the blood of Jesus to be broken out in the name of Jesus. Because that is the man to pray. And there must be a wrong to answer. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Bible told me about Hezekiah. Hezekiah was a king. And he accepted the Lord. But this one day, the Lord sent the prophet Isaiah. Said, go to Hezekiah. Tell him to put his house in order. Because today, you will not die. Let's go down with you. The Lord sent him to you. For your dream. Sorry. I'm so clear. The Lord will come to you. Put your teeth as small into the air. You put it in your baby. You are.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
The first thing we're going to do here, you
will start going to start the call. Hallelujah.
So you like the call, I'm going to be very call at you.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I'm about to let me call my prophet. The other place, the other place.
That was a complete something. It was interaction for one. You don't even tell why. It's emergency. Put your mask together, you die. No telepathy.
Somebody say amen.
The man of God knows something. He didn't say a word to the prophet. He turned his back and looked to the wall. Face to face to the wall. And said, God, you better mean this?
I don't think you mean this, Lord.
Lord, I am your faithful servant.
Hallelujah.
I have served you all of my life. I lived right. I did the right thing. I paid my tithe. I paid my offering. I support the widows. I support the motherless children. I was always there doing the right thing, Lord. Nobody had come for you. Lord, you can take me this time. Have mercy on me. I still got some unfinished business. I need to see my children graduate. I need to see some other project that I need to accomplish. Lord, you can do this. And I said, why you were still talking? Why you were still talking? The Lord told the prophet had not even left the palace. I believe he had come from downstairs on the first floor. The Lord said, hey, sir, go back up there. Something has changed. That will be something that will change in your life.
Amen.
Something will change.
Amen.
When you open your mouth, that's something change. That's something to in your family.
Amen.
That's something to in your marriage.
Amen.
That's something to in your child life.
Amen.
Something changed in the atmosphere. Amen. And God told him, go back and tell me that I don't know this. Now listen to me. If you stand to pray, God will add more years to your life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you will rise to pray, God will answer your prayers. You have more life. You have more favor.
Yeah.
You have more grace to your life. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As we about to close, soon closing. This woman called Anna. She was tired of her frustration. Tired of that her neighbor was calling her a witchcraft, eating everything in her womb. Yeah, I know some of our Lord who can come around and put fire on the hill in Jesus' name. She had a woman around every day. He ate all the children in your womb. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And she was tired of being talked about all the time. And she did not take her case with anybody but who? God. She come to understand that God said, ask. And you know what? Receive. Seek. So she said, you know what? Nowhere else I'm going to seek him or even in the house of God. I have not left my house, nothing happening. It's time for me to seek him where? In his house. Let me go and spend some time in his house. There are people who need to come and spend some time here. You can come yet in the church, you alone. That's true. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
You spend hours attending the church on the altar, laying before the altar, for God to speak. Why you stop? Bible says, we should pray about what? Season. Why did he stop? I come to encourage you. Let not your prayer stop. When your prayer stops, your life starts dying. When you start praying, you start to die. It's time to pray. I don't know when you told God, lie down before God and say, I'm not leaving from there just like Jacob until you are blessed. You understood that there is power in prayers. And until you are desperate, until you get to a place that you become so desperate, there can nothing happen to you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
As you got desperate, and God answered. But there was a man to pray. And because there was a man to pray, there was a God to what? Answer. Then God is always a very good job. We always want to answer our prayers. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah!
Or read this new scripture and then we close. Number one. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 8. Therefore I want the men everywhere to pray. Therefore I want the men everywhere to pray. Lifting up holy hands without anger and what? Disputing. I want men everywhere to what? Pray! Lift on your hands without anger. Don't go to pray with anger in your hands. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is so God of your heart. Somebody say amen. Men everywhere. So it is not limited. It includes you. It includes me. It's time to pray. It's time to pray. Get angry in your spirit and rise up and pray. Pray in your home. Your job. Pray in the street. The world we live in becoming more dangerous. You cannot afford to live on this earth without prayer. It's time to rise. Men everywhere you are, pray. Number two, Psalm 50 verse 15. Call on me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. When you call on God, He will what? Deliver you. I caution you to call on God. Don't feel less about yourself. Don't feel disappointed because you did not see answer to the prayers. Pray without ceasing. Continue praying. Number three, John 14:13-14. And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. I will do everything you ask me in my name to glorify my what? Father. This is God's promise to you. Why not ask God? Don't be afraid of God. He is your father. You are his daughter. You are his son. You have the right to the kingdom. Blessing is your heritage. Favor is your heritage. Prosperity is your heritage. Long life is your heritage.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
It's time to ask. John 15:7 said,
If you believe in me and my word within you, ask whatever you wish and it will be done for you. Ask whatever you wish. I say, without doubting, believe it, follow the instruction. The last one, John 16:23-24. In that day, you will no longer ask me anything. Very, very, I tell you, my Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. Until now, you have not asked for anything. Hear that? Until now, some of us are getting to the place that we don't ask God for anything. You are in a day that we don't ask God for anything until we have arrived now. He said, until now, you have not asked for anything. You ask for a blessing. If you ask, I'll give it to you. But until now, you have not asked me. You have never called me. I want you to call upon me. Ask me. And I, God, will bless you.
Amen.
I, God, will answer the prayers.
Amen.
Because I am a God who answers prayers.
Amen.
I am a God who answers prayer.
Amen.
Remember, Jeremiah 31, Jesus, I love you with my everlasting love.
Amen.
So ask me and I will answer you.
Amen.
First Thessalonians 5:17 says, pray with our seasoning. Don't stop praying. Now because you pray today, you don't see answers, you stop. Continue praying.
Amen.
Until your change comes.
Amen.
Continue praying. Until your what? Change comes.
Amen.
If God sees a man praying, God will answer that man.
Amen.
If there is a man standing praying, God will stand to answer.
Amen.
If there is a man praying, then God will be a God of answer.
Amen.
I want to stop to let you know God is watching. He's looking for a man who will rise up and pray. He's looking for a woman who will rise up and pray. If you can pray, God can answer. If you can pray, God can deliver. If you can pray, God can heal. If you can pray, God can set the mountain door. And you'll walk on the mountain as a dry land. I stop back to let you know. There is no father bigger than you. There is no devil bigger than the cross. There is no situation that will kill you if you can pray. Because a praying person is a willing person. A praying person is a determined person. A praying person is an overcoming person. A praying person shall never lack. To never lack. To never lack.
Amen.
I stop with this. I stop with this. Stop finding point. A gossip leader, the gossip about the pastors and leaders. Form a prayer group to encourage them, to support them. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Many of us are forming gossip groups, the gossip of the leaders. Why can't we form a prayer group to pray for our leaders? And that will bless them and bless us that are praying for them. Let the Lord help you. Let me strengthen you.
Amen.
If you are there to pray, God is there to answer.
Amen.
There are some prayers that must come from you.
Amen.
There are some prayers that must come from what? You.
Amen.
I don't care how any other person can pray. It must come from you.
Amen.
It's time to open your mouth wide and the Lord will fill it.
Amen.
Open your mouth wide and the Lord will fill it.
Amen.
It's time to do that. It's time to not rely on other people. It's time to rise up and pray.
Amen.
Stand up and pray. The Lord wants to hear the voice. And he wants to bless you. Last three of you.
The voice is praying. Pray like a telephone call. The voice is praying. He will answer.
We bless you for the word. Let the word form a place in our lives. Let us drop the word along with it. We bless you now in Jesus' name.
Amen.